So something you may need to do in Numbers from time to time is find duplicates. So say you have a list. Like I've got a list here, list fruits in one column and then the number of them in the other. But there's some duplicates. If you look through this list, there is apple several times, cherry several times, a few other duplicates. So how can you find them? Well, first, let's sort by the column that has fruit in it. Now you may have other columns that you want to sort by in the end, like say date or something like that. But for now, let's sort everything by the column that has duplicates. And there, sure enough, I could see that apple is there three times, there's cherry three times. And if I look enough, I'll find some other duplicates here as well. Here's orange there twice. Now if the list is huge, you're not going to want to look through it manually. So how can you get it to be done automatically, or at least semi-automatically, so you can check to see where the duplicates are and get rid of them easily? So we're going to use a bit of logic and a simple function to figure this out. So if this here, A3, is the same as A2, then we know A3 is a duplicate. So we'll start here in the second cell, because it doesn't make sense to do it in the first cell. There's nothing above it to compare it to. We'll start here the second row, row 3 in this case, and we'll say, start a formula and say if this equals this. And we're not using the if statement, we're just actually using an equal sign between the two. And we hit return and we see it says true. Now if we copy and paste that here, we'll see it says true for the next one because the third one's also a duplicate. But we go here where it starts with apricot and that's false, then true because there's a second apricot, false because avocado is by itself, bananas by itself, blackberries by itself, etc. And I can select all of the cells here. I just did that by double clicking on the C column header, paste it in, and then we'll get trues and falses depending upon what's there. Now of course it's not going to apply to the first one, but we could leave it there because it says false at least. So everywhere there's a true, we know we have a duplicate column. Now we could make it a little nicer. Instead of just using this formula here and have it be a true or false, we can use the if statement there, make the comparison the first part of the if statement and say if it is true, then we can put the word duplicate, maybe with an exclamation point. And if it's not, just a blank, so two quotes there, so a blank piece of text. And now when we copy and paste that throughout, we could see it's a lot easier to tell where the duplicates are. We can see all of the duplicate rows very easily, and we can go ahead and check them out and eliminate them. So let's say you want to take this a step further. Say you don't want to just eliminate the extra rows. You want to merge them. So you want to have the total count of all the apples, 202 plus 19 plus 121. Now you could do that manually every time you see the word duplicate. You could add them together. But it would be nice to have a formula to do it automatically. So let's increase by one more column here so we can work with this column. And let's put a formula here that's basically going to be the total. We're going to put equals and then we're going to say the count, so the same number. Then we're going to use plus and then use an if statement to say if the value in the first column is equal to the value in the second column, in other words the next one is a duplicate, then take the value of that. Now we don't want to take it from here. We want to actually take it from the same column. So we'll add up successive rows. Because if we took it from here, it would only add 19. It would never add the 121. We wanted to add the 19, but we want to have this one also have the 121. You'll see how it works in a second. So we say D3, the row below. And then the other option is 0. The 0 is when the next one is not the same. When we go from apple to apricot or cranberry to date, then it's going to add a 0 to it, so it'll not add the next one. We close the parenthesis there. So now we go and you can see it says 202 still. You think it would add the 19, but it's trying to add this one. So we want to copy this and paste it everywhere. So now we see 342, which is the correct count. What is it doing? Well, this first one here, I'd say the last row of apples, says 121 and the 192 does not match because apricot is different than apple. But here it's saying, okay, take the 19 and then apple and apple are the same, so add that 121, 140. Now here take the 202, then since apple and apple are the same, add 140 to that and you get 342, the total. So now what I want to do is I want to, instead of these being the results of formulas, I want them to actually be real numbers that are in there. And the same thing here. I don't want these to be results of formulas either because I'm going to move things around and sort them. So I'm going to select both of these columns. I'm going to do Edit, Copy, and then Edit, Paste Formula Results. So now this is really the word duplicate and this is really the number 342. They're not the results of formulas. Now the cool thing I can do is I can sort by the row C here in ascending order, and at the bottom I'll get all the duplicate rows. I can select all of those, delete them, and I'm left with all of the rows that have the correct count here in this column D here. I could then simply copy and paste it over here so I have the updated count numbers, or I could have just deleted this column and let this one replace it. Delete these right here. And now I've got everything there once with the complete total merged counts.